Today we are going to learn body movements, class 6, science, chapter number 8. Here, first of all, we have to understand what the lesson title explains, body movements. In body movements, we are going to learn that how the body moves and which organs are involved in the body movement. First of all, we have to understand what is the organ system. Organ system means a number of different organs, a group of organs when they are working together and they are performing a specific function. This is known as the organ system. In our human body, a number of different organ systems are working together, like digestive system, muscular system, respiratory system, nervous system, skeletal system. For example, in digestive system, the digestion starts from the mouth. In the mouth, mechanical digestion occurs, then it enters into the stomach where the chemical digestion occurs, and it enters into the small intestine, liver and pancreas, which secretes the important enzymes for the digestion. So we can say that mouth, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, liver and pancreas, a group of these organs are working together and performing a specific function here, that is the digestion. Same way here, for body movements, three organ systems are working together to perform this work. The first is muscular system, second is nervous system, and third is skeletal system. In this chapter, we have to learn the skeletal system. First of all, what is skeleton? You all already have seen what is human skeleton. So the question is that how many bones are present in human skeleton? In adult human, there are 206 bones are present. And in newborn, there are 305 bones are. And in children, there are 300 bones are present. Now we are going to learn what are the function of skeleton system, or what are the function of bone. The first important function is that it helps to give a framework to our body, or we can say it gives the perfect shape to our body. Okay? The second important function of skeleton system, that it helps to protect the delicate organ inside the bones. For example, heart. Heart is protected inside the rib cage, and the brain is protected inside the skull. And the third important function, that is related to our lesson, it helps in the body movements. You can jump, you can run, you can walk, you can ride. Everything that is because of the skeleton system, or that is because of the bone. Alright, now we are going to see the bones which are present in different parts of the body. The first is the skull bone. The skull bones are hardest among all the bones in our body. The skull containing two regions, the cranial and the facial region. The cranial region, in which our brain is protected, and it started from here to back part of our head, and the rest of the bones are known as the facial bones, and these facial bones that helps to give a proper shape to our face. There are 14 bones are present on the face, and the cranial region containing the 8 bones. So total 14 plus 8, 22 skull bones are present in human body. Here, these are the cranial bones and these are the facial bones. There are 14 facial bones and 8 cranial bones. So total 22 bones are there in the skull. Next is the spine bone. The spine bone is also known as the vertebral column or the backbone. In human, the spine extends run down from the neck to the hip region, and it is made up of number of small bones. A single small bone, that is known as the vertebra. A number of 33 vertebras in human that join together and form the hollow tube-like structure, and that form the vertebral column. From this hollow region, the other rubbery tissue is passed. This rubbery tissue is known as the cartilage. This cartilage is not hard as bone, that it is the flexible or smooth, so it can easily move. So our back can easily bend. This is the human vertebral column. Each a single bone is known as the vertebra, and there are about 33 vertebras that forms the human vertebral column. Are the rib cage. The human rib cage, in which the bones are come from the back and to the chest side. At the chest side, they are joined together. These bones are flexible and they come from the back to the chest region and form the box-like structure, a cage-like structure. That's why it is known as the rib cage. And the function of the rib cage is to protect the heart and the lungs. Here, in each side of the rib cage, there are 12 bones. The human rib cage, which joined at the front of this chest, and you can see here this at the back side, this is the vertebral column. So the rib cages, the rib bones are joined at the back side with this vertebral column. We proceed to shoulder bones. The human arm is made up of two parts, the upper arm and the forearm. The upper arm is from shoulder to elbow, and from elbow to wrist, this is the forearm. Here on the upper arm, there is only one bone, and in the forearm, there are two bones. Then after the wrist, here, the human wrist is made up of small bones, which are known as the carpals. And that's why we can move the wrist like this, in any direction. Now here, the other bones are the palm bones. Now our shoulder bones is made up of three bones. Here, this is the upper bone. The second bone is this bone, that is known as the collarbone. And the third bone that form the blade like structure here, that's why it is known as the shoulder blade. So collarbone, shoulder blade and upper bone that form the shoulder bones. This is the human arm, this is the upper bone, these are the two bones of the forearm, these are the bones of the fingers, and here this is the collarbone and this is the shoulder blade. Collarbone, shoulder blade and upper bone that forms the shoulder arm here.
Pelvic bone is also known as the hip bone. The hip bone is present at the end of vertebral column. Each pair of hips containing three bones and two hips are joined at the end of the vertebral column.
This is the structure of pelvic bone. Two hip bones are joined with the vertebral column here.
This is about the skeleton system of our body. Thank you.